Yesterday, well completed at that same, from that same point, today we are studying. Yesterday we talked about unity impulse and unit step response as given as an input and what will be the output. Now we are knowing that unit impulse that can be represented by delta n, that is 1 at n equal to 0 and 0 otherwise. So now if we are shifting this towards the right, because for causal we will shift towards the right, so it will be delta n minus k. Of course the value of k, the value of this signal will be 1 at n equal to k and 0 otherwise. What will be the representation? The representation will be just like this. This is n equal to 0, suppose this is n equal to k, suppose this is 1. So this will be just like this. Delta of n minus k equal to 1. Now, whenever we are taking this one as a particular thing, say we are knowing that y of n equal to f of xn. From yesterday's notation, we have seen this, that xn is the independent function and yn is the dependent function. So whenever there will be any change in the input, there will be subsequent change in the output. So now we are knowing this thing, that h of n minus k equal to function of delta n minus k, as because this is representing shifted response for unit impulse in causal form. We are knowing this thing. Now, how to find the convolution? As we are knowing that y of n equal to function of x of n, how we can elaborate this thing further? So if we will go by this, that in the limit of minus infinity to plus infinity, if we will expand this thing, then it will be like this. X of k, because now we are converting the n into k, h of n minus k, as we have seen. Now delta of f, for delta of n minus k, whenever we are finding the function of delta n minus k, we are getting h of n minus k, so we can write it like this. So the thing is, if we will proceed this thing further, then we can write that this n is nothing but equal to k only. So we can write this thing like this, k minus infinity to infinity x of k into function of delta of n minus k. Clear? So after that, if we will proceed further, then we can write this thing like that, it will be k minus infinity to plus infinity x of k into h of n minus k. So from here we are finding the convolution, and that convolution is telling us that y of n equal to h of n into x of n in their discrete domain which is equal with k minus infinity to plus infinity x of k into h of n minus k. This is nothing but known as the convolution sum.
Yeah.
So now, if we will proceed further, then we can see it over here that if we will go for unit step, then what will be this thing? For unit step, we are knowing that this is x of n, this is n, this is n equal to 0. Now suppose for unit step, whenever we are writing, we will start from here, then here, like this it will go. So we are knowing from unit step u of n equal to 1 at n greater than equal to 0 and 0 at n less than 0. This is for unit step. So if we will write over here u of n minus k, then what will be the representation? U of n minus k equal to 0 when n is less than k, and it is equal to 1 when n is greater than equal to k. So what will be the representation? The representation will be like this: x of n versus n, here n equal to 0. Suppose here this n equal to k, this is suppose 1. So this is the first value, this is the second value, this is the third value, this is the fourth value, and so on. This is n equal to k plus 1, this is n equal to k plus 2, this is n equal to k plus 3, etc. And like this, it will be going on. So now, if we will convert this thing in the form of convolution, so what we can find over here? So it will be like this only: y of n equal to h of k u of n minus k, because now u of n minus k is the input signal, this is the impulse signal, minus infinity to plus infinity. Just see the peculiarity. There we have found out that here it is delta of n minus k and here it is x of k. Just here it is changing like this. So from this we can write that u of n, if we will write this u of n equal to, then we can write it like this. Now the thing is, why we have written this thing? Delta of n, this is nothing but impulse, and whenever impulse is shifted, and if it will be shifted subsequently, if we can add all those shifting, then we can find the unit step. Now for step, if I will write m by m, we are representing this thing, by this m particular integer we are representing this thing, then this value will go from 0 to n, because by delta n we are representing this thing. So now what will be the representation for un and un minus 1? Let us see this. X of n, this is 1, this is for un, it will be going like this, n equal to 0. Now this is what, u of n minus 1, this will be going like this, similar way. So this is the portion, this area portion is being left, where we will find the value of u of n. Clear? So by doing this, we can find the relationship between unit impulse and unit step. So this is the relationship. Between unit impulse and unit step. Yesterday we have seen some problems related to linearity. Today we will see some problems related to time invariance and causality. And in my next lecture, we will cover Paulet-Wittner criterion. And as per Paulet-Wittner criterion, there will be the concept of stability, bounded input, bounded output, stability also will be coming. So let us do some problems related to time invariance and causality. Now what is this thing? We are taking this as time invariance. Yesterday we told this thing, that if y of n is function of x of n, then as per time invariance, we can write that y of n minus k equal to function of x of n minus k, and it can be related further like this, z to the power minus k function of x of n. So this is as per time invariance. Now let us take some problem and see if we are getting the solution for time invariance or not. Suppose question number 1 is given like this. If y of n is function of x of n and x of n equal to a n x of n, then check for its time invariance. How to do this thing? Now if we will do this thing, let us see for answer how we can solve this. As we know, y of n minus k equal to function of x of n minus k. So now just see over here. First we will do function of x of n minus k. That means a into n into x of n minus k Are you understanding this or not? Because now we will be going like this. And if I will do x of n minus k, let us see what we will get over here. We can get it like this, which is nothing but y of n. So first we are doing, or we can write like this also. Y of n minus k. First we are doing for function of x n minus k, then we are doing for y n minus k. Just see, this term and this term are dissimilar with each other. Now let us take another problem. If y of n equal to function of x of n and x of n equal to, this term is given as a x n minus 1 plus b x n minus 2. How to solve this? First answer, as we know, y of n minus k equal to function of x n minus k. So how to solve this? It will be like this: a into x of, instead of n, you just put over here n minus k, over here minus 1, plus b, instead of x, put over here n minus 1, minus 2. It will be like this. What about of y of n minus k? Again, y of n minus k will be equal with a x n minus k minus 1 plus b x n minus k minus 2. Hence, what we can write? Function of x n minus k is exactly equal with y of n minus k. The system is time invariant. So this is for time invariance. Now let us come to causality. Whenever we will go for causality, let us check what is the condition for that. Output of any system that is function of present or past value of input or either this or past values of output, or if you can take, so output, the present output will be depend on present or past values of input, or past values of output, or you can take both into the account. Suppose for causality, this will be the condition HN of 0 for N less than 0. This is the condition. Now suppose one question has been given to us. If Y of N equal to 3 of X N minus 2 plus 3 X N plus 2. This is the conditions. Check the causality. Just see, this is the past value of input, because present value of input is X of N. Past value of input will be X of N minus K. That K is given over here as 2. That is multiplied by one coefficient, that is 3. And this is the future value. Future value means X of N is the present value, X of N plus K will be the future value. So X of N plus 2 will be the future value, that is multiplied by one particular coefficient 3. So past and future is present over here. That means it's a non-causal. Next question. If Y of N equal to X of N minus 1 plus A X of N minus 2, what about this thing? X of N minus 1 past value, X of N minus 2 also past value multiplied by 1 coefficient. Now question 3. If Y of N, very important, X of minus N, that is on the negative side we are plotting. Causal will be always plotted in the positive side, not in the negative side. So this is causal, this is non-causal. Non-causal. So like this, we can check for causal and non-causal of several systems. So here in this video lecture, next lecture we will cover Paley-Wigner criterion, as well as we will cover in the next lecture with Paley-Wigner, we will cover the stability, and then we will cover the bounded input, bounded output stability, so that there will be an end of linear time invariant system, and after that we will go to the last part, that is random variables. Thank you very much.